What's happening, y'all? Hey, do you guys ever do anything just to kind of to keep yourself grounded, remind yourself from where you came from, you know, and just kind of go back and see what's happening? That's what I'm doing today. I'm at the Brighton Place Apartments. It's where I spent my years, 16 till I was 22 years old. This is what I called home. So if you knew me in high school, this is where I was, right? This is really what kind of shaped me. This is where I started really learning to dream as a young man, 16 to 22. A lot happens. This is where I was when I graduated. This is from high school. This is where I was when I got my art scholarship to go to college. This is where I was when I started learning to train birds. This is where I was when I learned that I was really, really good in sports and football and math, right in that apartment right there, y'all. Right in that apartment right there with me, my mom, Buffy, my little brother, Jamil, my little brother, and my pops. And what's interesting is not much has changed. If you ever want to know what kind of environment I grew up in, this is really it. And if you're from South Seattle, you know what the Brighton Place is about. I'll leave it there. You know what the Brighton Place was about. It was cool. It was lots of kids. It was lots of trouble to get into. You know, lots of dreams. And the apartment we grew up in first was actually right there. That one right there. That's the apartment I was living in when I met Miss Valerie. Yeah, I was 15 years old. Met Miss Valerie right there. We started dating. That's where I was going. I think I was there right when I got kicked out of Franklin. So, and there used to be a swimming pool here. Me and John Kelly and Michael Rollins and Tony Pryor and a lot of the old homies, man, used to come here. They've since filled the pool up. But, you know, other than that, it's still pretty much the same. But every once in a while, you know, I drive through here just to remind myself, man, because sometimes people, you know, you forget where you came from. You forget what the struggle was like. You forget what your parents, you know, had to put up with to help you get your confidence and get you secure. So every once in a while, you know, I drive back through here as a way to say thank you to my experiences, say thank you to my parents for, you know, doing the best they could with my little hard head butt. And also, I think about children that are in there now that are, you know, much like I was, you know, kind of low income. You don't know what's happening. They may be in trouble. You don't know what their future holds, but stay positive and keep them in, you know, keep them strong and keep them encouraged. You never know. They may turn out to be somebody wonderful, much better than me and you, right? And they may turn out to be just as good as us or like I said, much, much better. Just do this. I do this to stay grounded. Wonder, what do you guys do to stay grounded, to remind yourself from where you came from and to say thank you for all the experiences that you had? I'm curious. What do you do?